Welcome on Mercurial Mercenaries for the first album playthrough of 2018. First things first, come on, this is a community. Join the community of people watching me listen to music. Press subscribe. Why not? Now. Why am I shouting? It's because it's what I do. Would you like me to whisper to you, my mercenaries? Edvinus Sedekkis. Apologies if I've said your name wrong. Slasher Jasper, Red Hair 57. James Plowman, Jaspers, James Hill. The Scotsman, Michael Fuentes. You have all asked me to do a review of Tame Impala's album, Currents. Nothing to do with buns. Probably nothing to do with raisins, but I've got it, my mercenaries, I've got it. I just want to warn you, all YouTube advice tells you to be concise, 7 seconds, get in there, 4 minutes, get out. I think I want 2018 to be even more bloody rambling than 2017 was. So yeah, go ahead, thumbs down and switch over. This is my mercenaries. Currents by Tame Impala. Now, I've had some advice recently. I think it was All Them Witches or something, and they said two bits of advice, Mercurial number 6, please do a bit of research on the band, at least learn the track names. Couldn't deny, quite a good idea. He had another point as well, forget the other point. Learning the track and doing it, I'll admit, I've done no research. I'm quite tired today. I want some rock and roll to kind of cheer me up. I've done no research. I can't remember anything. I listened to Lonerism and I enjoyed it. If I remember rightly, it sounded very, very John Lennon and Beatles, and that's the vibe I got from it. And that's not a bad vibe to have. I don't know what to expect from Currents because it probably won't surprise you, my Mercurial Mercenaries, but I haven't done any research, even though you guys have advised me to do it. So, I'm just going to end in disaster one day. I don't know what to expect. Is this going to be Beatlesy again? Or is, was it Kevin Parker? Not Kevin Parker, Kevin Shields? What, Kevin Parker? Kevin Shields. What am I talking about? Okay, this is better. Without the plastic on it. Plastic. Overwhelming the seas. Without the plastic on it, it's not reflecting, so we can just look at it properly now. I didn't know what to think about this album cover when I first saw it. I didn't know whether this was good or not, but looking at it on the screen, that's not bad. And I suppose when I open this up now, I suppose we're going to find it's... Oh, my mercenaries. I'll tell you what, that's the sort of thing that used to strobe on old CRT... televisions, isn't it? That's quite nice, isn't it? Evil White Clown Punk! Gatefold! Gatefold! Ah! Yes, my mercenaries! What do you think? Like I said, I didn't know what to think, but when I see it in the flesh, when I see that in the flesh, I quite like it. Okay. I didn't know that. Good job I've got some time in it to enjoy this and cheer myself up. This is sort of 4 minutes in, we haven't even listened to the record yet. It's a double album! My mercenaries! So, I'm assuming this is the first album. Let's put the first album. What's it going to look like? Ooh. Okay. What colour's the album going to be, my mercenaries? What colour's the vinyl going to be? What colour's the vinyl going to be, my mercenaries? It's going to be black, isn't it? It's going to be black. It's going to be black. Here we go. Here we go. It's black! I kind of hoped it wouldn't be black then, just to sort of suss myself out, but it is black. Side A. Look at the cat. Look at the size of that cat hair. Can you see that cat hair on there? How does... It's because my mercenaries, I've got to admit, he sleeps in this... During the day, he sleeps in this chair. Little bugger. Right, okay, my mercenaries. This song is going to be Let It Happen. That's side B. Hang on. That's side B. That's side B, my mercenaries. So this must be, that must be side A, yeah? Side A. So this is going to be, yeah, Let It Happen. With the associated crackling from, not pork scratchings, but my cat. Here we go, my mercenaries. It's been a while. It's been a while. Oh, that sounds like... Oh, okay. 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 That's more dancey than I thought it was going to be. Perhaps it would have helped if I'd listened to it in a speaker. Lonerism before I pressed... Comparisons. Thirsty. These pretzels are making me thirsty. I'm really thirsty, yeah? I brought into this room beer Oh no, I've remembered it. Holy shit. I like this. Putting the filter on. In a minute we're gonna unsquelch. Here we go. First impression, liking it. As you guys have said to me, Mercurial number 6, you like everything. I think it's because you're recommending good albums to me. What am I supposed to do? Pretend I hate something? Oh. I drank that too eagerly then. Shut the door. Don't let the cat walk in him. Filters. Something's trying to get out. It's never been closer. If I never come out, tell my mother I'm sorry. Tell my lover I'm sorry. Tell my lava bread. Seaweed. I can't actually click my fingers. All the snacks are never. You get people who show off with the clicking of the fingers. They walk around all day long. They put bells on their fingers and bells on their toes and they just fucking do that everywhere they are. I can't do that. I'm gonna do that. I'm liking this. I like that. Yes. Like record stuttering. Unless I'm. No, it's alright. I'm not hitting the record player. Oh, okay. I picked up on that. And he's actually done it. Holy shit, I really, really, really thought my record player had fucked up then. I was about to spin around on my seat and correct it. And then I thought, this is recording. I'm gonna look like a dick. Which I didn't. That That is one deep, deep synth sound. On the last record, you could see what synths he was using. On this one, you can't see a lot, really. I like that. That is a good beat. I like a good beat. I'm not going to talk about beats all the time like Anthony Fantango Mellon does. He's obsessed with... I mean, there is more to life than beats, but that is a good beat. All vocals and instruments performed by Kevin Parker. All songs... I need to belch. I'm so sorry because I drank that stuff. I'm so sorry. I can't mix that in. I'm so sorry. What, like that? Oh. There's a bit of vocoder going on there, yeah? All vocals and instruments performed by Kevin Parker. All songs written, produced, recorded, and mixed by Kevin Parker. Basically, Kevin Parker did all of this. It's alright. When I do music here, all songs written, recorded, produced, mixed, recorded, instruments recorded, sung, recorded, instruments recorded by Mercurial number 6. I like that. Rhythmical sing. Yes! I like that. Holy shit, I like that. More like that. Additional recording and mix advice by Rob Grant at Poon's Head. I feel like I know this song. Does this sound like something else? Maybe it was a single, I don't know. Mastered by Greg Colby, New York City. I think I remember Lonerism was something similar to that. Yeah, I remember. Mastered in New York, I think. Gotta say my Mercenaries. This is groovy as fuck, isn't it? Cover concept, Kevin Parker. Artwork and design, not by Kevin Parker! By Robert Beatty. Photos... I suppose it means these ones. Photos. By Matthew C. Seville. We'll say Seville, not Saville. Seville. Thanks to friends and family. You know who you are. I should hope that they do. I should hope that they do. Endless love. Like that. Oh, there's some deep sounds here. Oh, yeah. Right. Okay, I'm hearing a bit of John Lennon in the vocals there. Sort of latter day. Oh. He's fucking with the pitch, isn't he? I'm noticing that. Either that or it's my record player screwing up. This has got... I like that. This has got like early 80s production values. And also, with the twisted warp sounds, it sounds very much like the Oxenfree soundtrack by Scientific for the game Oxenfree. I like that. Was that a whole song then? That was, I liked it. These beats are sounding a little bit Michael Jackson. I'm like Thriller era. I haven't got any lyrics to read. This is like, this sounds like 80s pop music, and it looks like 80s pop music. Don't mind that. Is this the moment? I want to be in the moment. Oh, I like that. Say, I want to live in the moment. Nice beats, recurring motif of the clicks, messing with pitch and messing with repeats, stuck vinyl repeats. Which in the ones and zeros world, that's sadly nostalgic, but when you're listening to actual vinyl, just, oh. That's an Atari 2600. That sounds like Space Invaders? Drum build up with nothing to follow. Yeah, very 80s. I can't remember what I said about lonerism now. I kind of vaguely remember saying Beatles and John Lennon. Was I getting more of a 60s vibe from Lonerism? So I'm getting an 80s vibe from this. Because I've done no research. What's the general vibe in the world about this album? 80s? I like that. I think that might be the end of side A, my mercenaries. The end of side A. You're going to join me for side B? Are you going to join me for side? Oh yeah, remember, press like, press no, thumbs up, press thumbs down, press subscribe, remember to do that. Rambling year for a rambling man. You're going to join me for side B, my mercenaries. Are you? Attention! Side B. I'm so happy that I'm gonna put on side B, and it's gonna feel so much like a cup of tea. a cup of tea. Side B, happy side B. Oh, yes. So this is going to be, yes, I'm spinning in circles. No, yes, I'm changing. Yes, I'm changing. Hopefully. Or like this. That's so lush, big 80s string synth sounds. Oh, yes. That sounds massive. Best song I've heard for ages by Mercenaries. Reminded me of if John Lennon was singing for the Cars. Who's gonna take you home tonight? Tonight. Wow, I loved that. I loved that song. I loved that song. John Lennon singing with the Cars with the Animal Collective in the background. Flaming Lips drums. Flaming Lips bass. John Lennon, The Cars, Flaming Lips, The Beatles. And I'm hearing Yes as well. The same album that I keep mentioning when I talk about King Gizzard. Fragile by Yes. And sort of Giorgio Moroder and Jean-Michel Jarre. There's something else it sounds like. The way he's singing, I can't place it yet. No, it's the Animal Collective, isn't it? Merivale Fairweather Cricket Pavilion. It's cool. Get whipped in the ashes! Oh yeah, and this is Australian bloke as well, isn't it? He's loving that. Bloody ashes. Who needs the ashes? To be honest with you, my mercenaries, that last song was worth the price of admission for an expensive double album. Liking the production, the drums and the bass so forefront in the mix. Of those synths, you know, you press one key and it's a buzzsaw. I like that. Everyone's so namby-pamby, yeah? This guy is just, fuck it. It's all called Eventually. Eventually. Yes, it is called Eventually. Eventually I cottoned on. Eventually I fucking twigged. I like that. I like that a lot with mercenaries. Yeah. very, so far this album's very... Do you know what I mean? If someone said, what's Currents like by Tame Impala, I'd say it's kind of... What does that mean, Mercurial number 6? It's been... A guitar. Is that the song? That's the song of Mercenaries! That was Gossip, was it? Okay. Who's gonna join me for side C? My viewers are tailing off. Join me on my Mercenaries for a journey to the center. It's funny when you can hear the rhythms that the vinyl creates. It's going, listen to this, my Mercenaries. It's going, you probably can't hear it. It's going, bum dun chicum bum ba ding, bum dun chicum bum ba ding, bum dun chicum bum ba ding. Darth Vader goes into a baker's in France and he says, can I have 3 loaves of bread, please, and 2 apple pies? And the guy behind the counter, I mean, he says it in French, but the guy behind the counter says, he says this bit in French. He says, what do you want? Qu'est-ce que vous voudrez? And Darth Vader says, I want 3 loaves of bread and 2 apple pies. And the baker, again in French, says, je ne, whatever I don't understand is in French, je ne pas, comprende pas. So Darth Vader says, oh, and he uses his limited knowledge of French, and he says, I need pan, 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 tartatan, tartatan. My father-in-law told that joke. Right, okay. Look, my mercenaries, side C and D, have a picture of a speaker and a picture of someone looking out of a window. And the vinyl is black. Okay, that must be side C, yeah? If we're following the things of last time, that'll be side C. And that, yes, that's right. So, side C, and we're starting with my mercenaries. We're starting with the less I know, the better. The less I know, the better. The less I know, the better. There's a bloody cat hair attached to the actual needle. Apologies for the sound sounding a little bit muffled. We were listening to Tame Impala's Currents through my cat's rejected hair. Fur, you'd call it. He's not... I haven't got a hairy cat. I've got a furry cat. I have a furry pussy, not a hairy pussy. It's alright. That's the sort of joke you get at the beginning of The Last Jedi, my mercenaries. Because it starts with Edward Hitler. Edward Elizabeth Hitler. I've forgotten what I said this song was called, but I think it's probably going to be good. No bass. There's the bass. And Dexy's Midnight Runners. Dexy's Midnight Runners piano in the background. yourself together. You should try to bluff in heaven. Bass. Something tells me that Kevin Parker enjoys playing the bass. Tame Impala fans out there, am I right? Kevin Parker enjoys playing the bass. Maybe more than any other instrument. What do you reckon? I do. I've said loads of times. I used to say to Bill all the time, on my other half of the 11th Hour Initiative, on the occasion that we're together. I think the bass is the most fun instrument to play. And you can do the faces, the Haim faces. Haim. H. I'm not mocking her. It looks like I'm mocking her. But I love her. She's great. I almost gave that Haim album my album of the year a few years ago, purely because of it sounds more 70s now. Kind of, do they know it's Christmas time bells? And still with the Come On Eileen piano. Thought we need to be wearing big Northern soul clothes. Ooh. Mahoney, I'm a virgin! Oh yes. The fight begins! Now! Charlie Watts thing. Notice Charlie Watts from the Stones. If he hits the snare, he's not hitting the hi-hat. Seriously. Most drummers. Charlie Watts. quite important or relevant now. I like drums put through distortion and phasers. I like that cashmere sound on God, what bloody album's Cashmere on? Physical Graffiti, isn't it? Yeah. John Bonham's kit just put through a phaser pedal. Sounds like that. Anyway. Phaser pedal there, is it? Different from side A and B. It's all. Imagine playing the drums like this. Very straight back. Play that with a smile. Like with Dave Clark 5. Get a squelch. Couldn't help himself, could he? Like that, the drummers of the 60s, like Ringo. They have their drumsticks, they hold a tambourine in one hand as well. So as they're drumming, the tambourine's going. Either that or you have you just have Mick Jagger just whacking it incessantly out of time. But even then, something about some of those early Rolling Stones songs with the tambourine being hit out of time. If it was hit in time, it would be a worse for it. Worse for it. Here's that big sound again from the first record. From side A and B. Side A and B has finally penetrated side C. I like that. this is a good start to my album listening of 2018 with Mercenaries. So thank you, those people I mentioned at the beginning. Thanks for recommending this album. We ain't got to the end yet. Side D might be a pile of shite, so I don't want to speak too soon. Through the paper like a blade of grass.
Oh,
I nearly got it. Hang on. Oh, tell it. Hang on, I tore it. Hang on, we can do it. We can do it, my mercenaries. We're not going to get to side D until I've done it. Well, that sounded nothing like that bass line, though, did it? Which was the whole point of it. Are you going to join me for side D, my mercenaries? Are you? Are you? Are you? Yeah, you are. Are you? No. No? You've already gone? Holy fuck. Well, it is cheering me up. Side D. And the final beer, I think. Okay, side D. I mean, even the fact that we've got a side D. It's like a sardine. But it's, you know, you don't have to chew through the bones on this. Not that you have to chew a sardine ever. Here we go, my mercenaries. Side D, not sardine. Ooh. Vocals are a wash. They're a wash. Like that drums. Such. Oh, wow, we're suddenly getting mad drums. For the first time on the album. Not a repeating pattern on the drums. He's throwing the kitchen sink in on the drums. Oh, he's using shakers. I've got to say, most of my songs I put shakers on. There's something really soothing about that. Do you know what? If I listen to that all night, just this, I could probably go to sleep easier. I like it. Finally, like I say, mad drums. You might have noticed my mercenaries, but I like a bit of mad drums. Thank you. Oh, I like this one. Oh, I like this one. Reality in Motion gets a thumbs up. And what was the one I really like on Mercenaries? First song on side B. Yes, I'm Changing, was it? Parker got any collections to the Animal Collective? I'm hearing a lot of that as well. He hasn't got any collections at all. You looking at me? I don't see anyone else here. Are you looking at me? Who the fuck do you think you're looking at? The moments on this album where it's just a wash and epic, those moments where you can feel like the wind blowing and you just want to put your arms in the air, and this is one of those moments. Keyboard. Separations by Pulp. Oh. Now that is a beat. That is drums and bass. This sounds like 80s film soundtrack. Something filmed between 80 and 85.
I'm not afraid to
Workers marching. I can imagine workers marching in Metropolis, the old Fritz Lang film. This song, I said the last song sounded like that. This song sounds like claustrophobic. This song sounds small and tiny, like we're trapped. Is this how we're going to end this album? We're going to end this album trapped in a small place together. Just the two of us. Trapped. Are we trapped? Are you and I trapped here in the world of Tame Impala and the Mercurial number 6? If I've got anything in my teeth now, it's not going to be good. Not going to be good for my self-esteem, my mercenaries. That's gonna get me some comments, isn't it? Down! I'm gonna get some Mercurial number 6! No! We can do without you trying to be sexual with your tongue and your lips while we're trying to listen to Tame Impala! I think you're watching the wrong channel with Mercenaries. This album plays a lot with removing the bass from the frequency spectrum, I mean. So then when you squelch it back in again, it hits you. And they're going to do it in a minute. Probably after this. Probably now. The Perfect 10 does that all the time. If the Perfect 10 ever says something's going to happen, if she ever forecasts, prophesizes something, put your money on the opposite, because it won't happen. Is it finished? Shit, sorry my mercenaries. It's finished. That was side D. That was Currents. Okay. That was Currents by Tame Impala. And I, no surprise, we've said it before, when's Mercurial number 6 not going to like something? Oh, well, fuck it. Hey, fuck it. Life's too short, my mercenaries. This is 2018. This is the year of more nonsense than ever before. I enjoyed that. There were moments there that were good. There were moments there that were average. And there was one moment in particular that was my highlight of music for a long time. So, as I said, when that song happened, it was worth the price of entry. I have to, therefore, give Currents by Tame Impala. 11 o'clock, my mercenaries. It gets 11 o'clock. Let me know what o'clock you would give it below. You've listened to it with me. Some of you, okay, probably, let's face it, probably the majority of you have heard that album before, and therefore that's why you're watching this. But some of you out there, especially my long-term Mercurial mercenaries, will never have heard that album before, and you'll have heard it with me for the first time with me, then, like that, there. So, my Mercurial mercenaries, what do you think, my Mercurial mercenaries? What o'clock would you give that album, my Mercurial mercenaries? Keep the suggestions coming for more albums to listen to. I have got a long list already, but unlike other channels, I value my subscribers and my subscribers' comments. And if you don't believe that by now, then there's not a lot I can do about it. But thank you for watching. And this is 2018, my mercenaries, and let's see what we can do. Let's see if we can make all of our lives better, okay? So, over and...